Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Civil Engineering Forum, where we are in the third part of the topic connection, and today we are going to continue with the bolted connection. That is the introductory part of this bolted connection. So it is also known as black bolts, secret bolts or unfinished bolt. These are designed as per IS 1363-2002. This is a figure of a particular black bolt we can see on the screen, where this is the shank. This is the threading of the bolt. This shank plus threading is known as the overall length. This is the flange of the bolt. Let me change the cursor. Okay. These are the dimensions of the black bolt. 1.65 into diameter. This is the dimension of the flange. This is the thickness of the flange, that is 0.65 into diameter. Whatsoever is the diameter of this shank. Here I have shown D is the diameter, nominal diameter we are talking about. And see this dimensions written by this blue sketch pen are the dimensions of the high strength bolts and nuts. This is the second type of bolt we will be studying in the next lecture. But right now we are talking about only the black bolt, so we have to just see this black colored marker. 1.65 into diameter, 0.65 into diameter, this is D, that is diameter of the shank. Overall length, that is shank plus thread. And if we talk about the nut, here also we have to just see the black colored marker, that is the thickness of the nut should be 0.8 into diameter, and the width of the nut, or we can say the diameter of the nut, is 1.65 into diameter of this shank. So this is the diagram of a black bolt. Now we'll see its specifications and its use. Black bolts are made up from the mild steel rods with a square or a hexagonal head and nuts. So just let me change again the cursor. Black bolts are made up of mild steel rods. This is the material by which black bolts are made, mild steel. Now we're talking about its shape. It might be a square or hexagonal head and nuts. This is also referred as ordinary, rough and unfinished or common bolts. By the name itself, we can say that it is very ordinary, and we cannot use it where there is very heavy loading. These are mainly used in small structures under static load, such as small trusses. These are only used in small structures which are under static loads, which do not have very heavy loading. These are the small trusses, the example of this. See, either we can use it in the structure where there is very less load or a small structure, and second option is these are used as temporary fasteners during erection where high strength friction grip bolts, HSFG bolts or welding are permanent solution. See, where we are going to use the high strength bolts and welding is to be done, there we can use this black bolt as a temporary solution, as a temporary fasteners. Then we can remove this and use high strength friction grip bolt. These are the bolt what we will be studying in the next lectures. Or even the welding is the permanent solution. There we can use this as a temporary solution where it can be removed later on. And it is not recommended for connections subjected to impact, fatigue or dynamic loads. See, if there is any impact load, there is any sudden load or fatigue load or even dynamic loading is there, then we cannot use these types of black bolt, because we know that it is not made up to carry very heavy loading. And it is not having enough strength, and the material used there is mild steel rods. So moving ahead, in steel construction, generally bolts of property class 4.6 are used. See, here we are talking about black bolt, and the class 4.6 black bolts are most commonly used. The number 4 indicates 1 out of hundreds of the nominal ultimate tensile strength. See, what does this 4 stands for is 1 out of 100 of the nominal ultimate tensile strength. That is, this is the only one part out of the 100 part of the tensile strength. So we can multiply directly this 4 with 100 to know its tensile strength. If you want to know the tensile strength of any particular class of the bolt, then we need to just see the first point, the first figure, that is 4. If it is 4 here, then we can multiply directly with 100 and guess the tensile strength as shown here. And it is abbreviated by FU. Fu is 4 into 100, that will be equal to 400 newton per mm square. So the ultimate tensile strength of class 4.6 is 4 into 100, that is 400 newton per mm square. See, right now we are not talking about this 0.6, that is digit after the point. We just had a discussion regarding the first digit. Then the number 6 indicates the ratio of yield stress of the ultimate stress as a percentage. See, now talking about this digit after the point, it is the ratio of yield stress to ultimate stress as a percentage. So it is basically the percentage of the ratio of this yield stress and ultimate tensile stress. So now we can directly convert this 60% of what of this 400 newton per mm square. So what is the 60% of Fu? It will be around 240 newton per mm square. This is the yield strength. So now we can just, I need to remove this eraser. Okay. This 4 stands for the ultimate tensile strength, and this digit after the point indicates its yield strength. That is 60% of 400. That is 240 newton per mm square is its yield strength, and 400 newton per mm square is its tensile strength. Now, taking another example, for class 8.8 bolt. Okay, so now we'll study what is 8.8 class black bolt here. So Fu is 8 into 100, that is ultimate tensile strength will be this 800 newton per mm square, depending on the first digit. Now the digit after the point indicates 80% of this ultimate tensile strength. That is Fy will be equal to 80%, 0.8 into 800, that will be 640 newton per mm square. So this is its yield strength, and this will be its ultimate tensile strength. So this was about the only the bolts, and we are not talking about the nuts here, but we'll see this next. For 4.6 grade bolt, percentage elongation will be 22% and are ductile. See, these black bolts of 4.6 grade are ductile. That is because it gives us about 22% of elongation after the limit is reached. Then talking about the nut, as I said, for bolt of property class 4.6, see, if our class of the bolt is 4.6, then the nut what we are using for the particular bolt is of class 4. Nut of property class 4 are used. We are not considering this yield strength in the designing of the nuts. Again, for bolts of property class 8.8, if we are using the bolt of property class 8.8, then the nut of class 8 are used. So this is just an example of the class of the nut. And next we'll be talking about, sometimes a hole is drilled in the bolt and a cotter pin with a castled nut is used to prevent the nut from turning on the bolt. See, sometimes it so happens that our nut keeps on loosening and our structure might be unsafe. So at that time, what we can do is, we can just tighten our nut here. We can just fix our nut over here. We can tighten it. Let me draw it very clearly and remove this. I will take a pen. If I am fixing a nut over here, see, here. If I am fixing a nut here, like this. Sometimes it may so happen that due to vibrations and dynamic loading or whatsoever, this nut will come out or it will loosen. So at that time, what we can do is, I'll just remove this. We can take this cotter pin and insert in this hole. If we insert this in hole, then we can prevent this nut to come out of the hole. So if we insert this cotter pin in this hole, then we can prevent this nut to turn around the threading. So this was the use of the cotter pin. Friends, today we talked about what is black bolt, that was first type of bolt, and in my next lecture we'll be talking about the high strength bolt, that is the second type of bolt in the bolted connection. So thank you for watching, and wait for the fourth part of the topic connection.